How about that tonight? Okay? We're talking Timmins Arena with the NIT logo on it, packed out on March 20th. You know what they usually do around March 20th around here? The lights are off in the office because they're recruiting on their own vacation. And instead, we had basically a sold-out building with a ton of energy with an American Conference team in here, and our kids went toe-to-toe with them. That's what you call progress.
They've been playing college basketball at Furman University for 98 years.
Get the roll. There he is. Derek Waugh is playing now for Furman. You look at all those championship banners. Furman dominated the Southern Conference in the late 70s.
And if you didn't have them believing before, they are all din now in Greenville.
I'm all in on FU.
They have knocked off two of the final four teams from last year. It wasn't luck either. It wasn't a fluke.
You know what's better? For the Paladins being ranked for the first time in their history.
Yeah, I think they're very good. Yeah, they're going to beat a lot of people.
Furman's one of those surprise teams. I care. They could be Loyola and Chicago this year.
Seconds. Lions. Now Rafferty with five. With three. Mounts throws down the slam with 1.6 left.
Mark gets three. Look at that. Big time. Rafferty right back outside. Gurley for a three.
Come into Villanova and give him a fight.
That's the free throw.
Right.
And then who makes the big shot to put us up six late?
Talking about at the highest level, when you can keep your pace and you can keep your poise.
Defending on balls inside and the first move inside. This is the first basket of the game for Matt Rafferty. And off the miss, an offensive rebound. Lions again, he's not shy. Boneheaded play as usual. Rafferty with a reverse lay-in. Good close defensively. And now from the corner. Back in the ball game, firing down long move. Up on top, Hunter answers back with a three. Now Gurley, they can't take to the hole. but they leave the shooter open on the other side. It was a good catch on the inside. He's got size on Gillespie. Gets his feet set. Hunter's hit some big shots in this game. Long range for Mouse. Got it for three. Wow. You talk about toughness. Rafferty back it in on Bruce. Got it. What a huge shot. Celebration time for the Paladins of Furman, who come into Villanova and knock off the defending national champions in overtime.
How about that? That was fun.
You know, it's just a credit to how close this group is and how committed they are to working hard, but also to believing in the way that we have to continue to play.
Team is perfectly suited for the offense that Coach Ritchie has for us.
They'll try the two, and it's stuck back in by Rafferty. Fender on his backside, don't force him to go get it. He puts it up and in. Uh-oh. Look out now.
Rebound pulled away by Mounts to Clark, back to Mounts.
That's where I was going with Dasher, Dancer. Mark down to Rafferty, and he scores with the left hand.
Just come, all right? I'm hearing the things about trying to figure out student tickets. Those are called winning problems.
Students showing up 72 minutes before the game. No, that's a little different for us.
Rafferty.
unbelievable, and I mean, words can't really explain how much we appreciate it.
Backing in on Bowser, spins, left hand scores. The hurry. Clark all the way down the lane, drives! Baseline fadeaway jumper blocked by Clay Mouse, then throws it off.
Over to Mount, right in front of the student count at Clay Mount.
Back again against Knott now. He gets free with the left hand. And now Clark for three. Yes!
The pass in, out to Gurley for three, no problem. it on the floor, and that's how you get out of trouble.
Furman is 22-4. They're one of the top mid-majors in all of college basketball. Yeah, we hooking back up. And when they bang us in the club, baby, you got to get up. Cause homies thug, homies, yeah, they giving it up. Low lie, yo lie, boy, we living it up. Taking chances while we dancing in the party.
Moment ago, here's Rafferty taking Hamilton, yes! Looking at me strange, but you know I don't care. Bounce for three out of the corner, yes!
Bounce on. Here's the crowd loads up from the outside.
Take a bullet with some grip and take the smoke on this jet. Out of town, put it down. He picks it up. Gurley to the basket.
Get back, that's the part of success. If you believe in the S, you'll be relieving your strength.
Nice slip to Rafferty in the layup.
Hunter with a step back three. He has been lethal. Corner three from Andrew Brown. Got it.
Rafferty, a very unselfish player. Lions is going to get fouled, and he hits the three. City on Nolan. Right to Lockage. And a great block. Hunter will follow, keeps it alive. Bothwell's three, good.
Knocks it in to cut the deficit down to eight.
Can the Paladins answer? Yes, they can. Down to seven. Hunter, shed a defender, finds Rafferty.
Hold up. Another double-double from Rafferty the other night. He had 9 points, 9 rebounds in the first half.
There's a cut. Go back, Hamilton down. Contact.
Oh, I'll tell you, there's Mounts again. They are shooting the daylights out of it from the outside.
Well, 2-point lead down to 14. Rafferty got his hands on it, found the cutter.
Rafferty against Beeland. Nice move in the paint.
Nice to Rafferty. Here's a three for Furman.
Down to Easley, back out to Rafferty again. Through the paint, works around Smallwood. Down low, working against Elmo. 6-8 for 6-8. Look at that, Rafferty with 11. Backdoor cut to Mounts, reverse layup. Rafferty works around Easley.
Now Rafferty's got a step.
And I powered up strong that time. Here's Rafferty.
Here comes Rafferty. And the wife.
That will do it. A 21-point win. Paladins are 24-6, 13-5 in the Southern Conference.
During the game, you can definitely feel the fight. You can definitely feel the battle, and you know those. It only makes you go harder.
What they've done is incredible. And, you know, nobody knew this. We didn't really talk about it. Matt Rafferty has had a torn labrum for a month and a half. The trainer was worried about it. He just kept playing. And that's what he does. And Andrew Brown went through everything he went through this offseason. He just kept fighting for this program and this team. And I'll remember the fight and the resolve of those two people for the rest of my life.
Let's go.
Jordan took a shot, and everyone in the gym trusts him with that shot.
Next year, hopefully, we cut those nets in Nashville and we can play in the NCAA tournament. And that's going to be our goal, and we're going to work our butts off for it.
Just tell you something. I'm making tough for this guy. What he's been through, we basically had to keep everything a little bit hush-hush. Don't make them tougher. We need everybody. We're gonna need the student body. We're gonna need this community. We're gonna need Greenville. We're gonna need the media. We're gonna need everybody that is gonna try to make this a powerful program in the city of Greenville that Greenville will be proud of. Let's keep this going, right? And we're gonna have 8 months to get better. We're gonna have 8 months to go to work every single day and be deliberate about where areas where we gotta improve in. I've got to get better as a coach. Every single person in our program's got to get better. Every single player in our program's got to get better. And we reload and we go again next year.
It was a big achievement for us, and it was a great opportunity. We camped a little bit short tonight, but I know Jordan, I know the rest of this team, like they're going to be back even stronger next year. And can't wait to watch them play.
Yeah, I mean, Matt, I don't know the answer to that because, and look, I have utmost respect for Belmont. I've watched those guys for years, and Rick Burr does a phenomenal job. But is it really scheduling? I mean, because our league is clearly better than the OVC on paper. We do have the Q4 loss with Samford, but you know their loss at Green Bay is similar, and if not worse. And so, you know, we've got the Villanova win, they've got the UCLA win. I mean, and look, they deserve to be in. I just think there deserve to be more. I mean, I love the fact that Belmont's in, but I'm lost as the fact of why Greensboro and or us are not in the field. And really, I can't tell you. I mean, we went out and played the national champs. We played another Final Four contender. Our league had Q1 games in it. And so I don't know the answer to it. I haven't really heard anything since the selection show to say, hey, here is the reason and here's what they need to do. So I wish I could answer your question better, Matt, but unfortunately I'm not sure what to answer that would be.
Don't say we're gonna be here when the world would stop.